Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I am starting a brand new Let's Play series on Farming Simulator. Now I've got a couple of extra maps. I got the, I think it's pronounced Soznovka. Someone from Eastern Europe, please correct me if I've got that wrong. Is it Soznovka or Soznovka? I think it's slightly softer S in the middle, but anyway, that doesn't matter. I've been having a look at Sandy Bay, and I've been having a look at Melbury Estate. I'm thinking that we're going to go for Melbury Estate first, because I'd like to sort of get established with the Let's Play before I start trying to play around with soil mod and stuff like that. Melbury Estate, I feel, is a good one to start off with. It's a really well-made map, but it can, I think it would be slightly more forgiving for starting it. So, welcome to Melbury Estate. You have brought this estate and it's been handed over halfway through harvest, so you must bring in the planted crops to bring in an income. The map has pig, beef, fattening and compost mod. Well, actually, it doesn't have the compost mod anymore. That bit was removed because it wasn't working very well. Your produce is sold at local pub and there is a local BGA plant where you can turn silage into manure for the fields. Collect water at the river and we don't use the compost. Feed your animals with the right foods to increase their productivity and keep your ground topped up with nutrients to get the largest yield. Enjoy your stay at Melbury Estate. Thanks to everyone who's involved with the map and support that you guys have been giving. Thanks, Tomex55. He is the creator, and Tomex55 has done a fantastic job of making this map. Now, I've got a few mods installed. I've got the PDA mod installed here so that we can have a look through things, and it's just remembering the controls and everything for the new PDA. Let's just take a quick look at the map that we've got. So we've got, there's a farm to the south, there's a farming area in the middle, and there's a farming area to the north. And then I think you've got a shop over here. Let's go to the next. Does it show it over here? No. Let me come out of there and we'll go to 9. There we go. So we can see the biomass heating plant up in the top right. We got biotech over in the left. The biomass is where you put the wood chips, and then the biotech, that's the silage. Beef and pigs in the middle on the left. That's where you sell them. It's not where you put them. So let's just take a quick look around the farm and see what we've got going on here. A few sheds and storage. We've got a few basic machines, and we've only got, let me just put the time down. Now, one thing I will say, I've said that I want to do this as realistic as possible, and what I will do is I will play in real time, and then when we have no jobs to do, I will simply fast forward time. And that is not being unrealistic, that is simply representing the farmer's downtime when he's having meals, he's sleeping at night, that sort of thing. Everything else I have got as realistic as possible. I've got the opening gates and so on. So this is the cow field in here, cow pasture in there. And so we've got that we own all of that. So let's just shut the gates there. We've got, there is a silage bunker here. And the various storage yards. I think this is another silage bunker in here, fill level 0%. So I'm assuming that is there. And one thing that I wasn't so keen on with this map is there isn't any automatic filling point for your crops. I'm not really sure what I want to do first. You know, I've had a bit of a look around here. We've got quite a few fields that we actually own. One, if you look in the middle there, you've got 1, 2, 6, 7, 9, 42, 43, 8, 41, 15. And then we've also got a big one in 5 and in 22. Now, several of these are planted. If we go and have a look on the map here, we've got 34 and 35 are growing. Those are just grass. So we don't need to worry about those. Then we've got 15, 41, 8, 7, 9, 11, and 43 all ready to harvest. And let's take a look. So we've got sugar beet down there. This one here is that sugar beet again? Oh, no, that's not sugar. That's barley down there, ready to harvest. Grass, corn ready to harvest there, but I don't think this map has got anywhere you can sell corn. And if that's the case, we need to turn that into silage. We've got number 16 over here, that's more barley ready. The sugar beet, canola there, more canola up there. So we've got a lot of stuff that is ready to harvest, which it might be difficult to get the whole lot in now. I'm going to ask a question every single episode. I will ask a question. My episode today, Do you want me? At the moment, that's on normal, and we got plant withering on. Now, I'm suggesting that we turn plant withering off so we don't lose all of those crops that we got in the fields because we don't have the machinery to get them. I do have the mod that we can use to rent machinery, so that we could rent some machinery to take a look at it, but it's not, it still has an awful lot of stuff that we've got to harvest in order to be able to complete everything and make sure that we get everything in on time. So I'm suggesting we turn plant withering off just to sort of add to the effect of it. Which way do I want to go out of here? I think I'm going to go up that way. Go left. Just see if I can get out here. Come on then. Right. The nice little tractor that we got here. I'm not going to be using massive machinery, I don't think, for this map. Just turn the indicator off. I don't want to forget to do that. So I won't be using massive machinery for the map, but at the same time, I do want to use, something of an appropriate size. And while we're just driving up here, I'm not going to be showing you all of my driving all the time. That is just going to get tedious. But we're just going to have a little bit of a look around and decide what we're going to do first. I think that we're going to nip in with a combine onto one of these fields here. Let's just take a look up here. There's a gateway in that way. And what's in there? I think that's oops, sorry, mate. Sorry. Let me just come in here out of your way. We've got, what's this in here? What's this field? Field here. I think this is the canola in here. Let me just pull in off here. Tend to indicate too much when there isn't much traffic around, but yeah, this is canola. That's a really nice texture actually for the canola. I really like that. That is awesome. I'm tempted to harvest this field first. We won't be storing much in the way of crops because oop, no, I don't want that one. I want the PDA, and I need to cycle through like this. At the moment, we got some wheat, barley, canola, potatoes, and sugar beet. We don't have any oats, which is the other one that this map supports. So that is everything that we can get on this map. And then the price is commodities. Just ignore the corn bit. We got the pigs, the fattening units, and the rest of things like that. So we'll probably, as we harvest, take it straight over and sell it. This is a nice big field to start off with. I think we could get quite a bit out of this one. It's just what machinery do we have that we can use? So let me just take a look up and down, back up onto here. And I'm just going to have another look at the map. Right, so oh, that's field five that we're up against. I want some trailers and stuff. And I'm going to need a combine. Let's park this tractor here and see what other machinery that we've got for a minute. I'm just going to put him in down here. Now, at the moment, I don't have anything like the Follow Me mod, which would be very useful. So we're just going to cycle through the machinery like this. This isn't unrealistic. It represents a farmer walking a great distance, or getting his wife to come and pick him up in the car and bring him back to the yard, as normally happens with farmers. So we've got a nice combine here. That's down the farm that we started with, I think. This yard here, although we're up near 47 now, up the top. So we've got, oh, this is the beef and the pig area up here. And let's just take a quick look around. I'll hop out and we'll take a stroll. Let's run around here. So we've got some tipping points here for various crops. I'm not quite sure which one goes where. It's a job to tell. We've got storage sheds. And like I said before, what we don't have, just open the door here. I do love these sliding doors. These are absolutely brilliant. And there's quite a few of them around. But what we don't have is anywhere that automatically loads our machinery. So we've got, I think, this one is pigs by the sound of it. And so I would make the other one over through here, would make this one the cows. So we will get to that. It's not something we're going to do straight away. And What else have we got around here? This is more grain storage. You've got grain storage there, and then this one is potato storage, by the look of it. Yes, that's potatoes. So where is the sugar beet? Sugar beet storage is the one I'm not sure about. I haven't actually located it yet. I did take a bit of a look around this map beforehand. That wall there, just, it glitches ever so slightly. It's like moving backwards and forwards. Look at that. Yeah. That's about the only problem I've been able to find with the map. And that is pretty good. So, Tomix55, if you ever listen to this video, well done, sir. You have done a magnificent job with this map. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's fantastic. And the level of detail. I mean, we've got the old Lizard 2850C. I believe that is from one of the early Farming Simulator games. I didn't actually start playing them until number 13 came out. So some of these references may be lost on me. However, I have spent a lot of my early life working on farms all over the UK. So I've seen all sorts of farms, and this is much more realistic with old battered machinery lying around. You get that a lot. You get that a lot on farms everywhere. We've got a water bowser there, fuel point here. Right, let's cycle through a few of the other machines. We've got this one here. There's our combine. Tractor with a loader on it there. That is a slightly stronger tractor, the Steyr, that is. That's how it's pronounced. Not really sure. And we've got the old classic and the AgroStar 661, the Deutz. And I think we're going to use this one. What crop is that in there? I was thinking that we would go and start working on the canola harvest. Let me just run out across the road here. Can I climb through the hedge? I really want to climb through the hedge. Let's go over here. Jump over the fence. Right. Oh, we've got... This looks like wheat. No, that's barley. That's barley. So we've got barley in here. Is this one of our fields? Field 9. Yes. Oh, that's the barley right down the bottom. So do I want to go to number 5? I'm going to do canola first up in field 5. So I'm going to start getting the machinery up there. And then we can get started with our harvest. And I will at some point use the auto combine mod. Let's see if I can bring that one. I took the trailer with me. Come on, back up a bit. Back up, Frith. There we go. Right. Yes, I will at some point use the auto combine mod, but I don't have it at the moment. And the same with course play, I don't have that one either. So both things that I am going to do, but I'm not doing them yet. Can't see very well out here. Tractor coming through. You do need to sort of pause in your driving when I'm coming up through. And right, I think we'll get everything up to the field and get ready to start harvesting. We've got a lot of work ahead of us. I think we've got a little bit of a problem here, to be honest. Let me just come over and we'll open up the gate so that we can get out. But no, the problem that I think we might have is how are we going to get this combine up the road? That is a big header. That's an 18-foot cut header, that is. I think we're going to need to, and we don't have one, I think we're going to need to go and get a header trailer. Let me just see if we can... It's a bit difficult driving one of these when you're in here. We can get out here, okay. Which way do I want to go? Want to go down that way? Yes. I have to spin round. And I don't know if that trailer is in the way. Am I driving it very good sometimes? Okay, nice and steady. But we can get past that trailer, all right. Now, which way do I want to go? To come out of the cab so that I can see a little better, I think. Come round here. We've got the Weybridge sign right there in the middle. Now, I can get out onto the road. But then, can I get up the road without hitting traffic? Because if I can't, I'm going to have to go and get a header trailer. I have to look like this. This isn't the way that we want to do this. Normally, if you were doing this... right, this is taking up the full width of the road, and cars aren't going to be stopping. So I'm going to have to reverse back in and I'm going to have to get a header trailer. Normally, on a normal working farm, if you were to do this, you would send someone up the road first and they would stop the traffic for you. So then it wouldn't really be an issue. Unfortunately, we can't stop the traffic. So if I back in here, just like this, let's turn off that indicator, I'm going to need to go and get the header trailer. And I think what we'll do is I will go and get the New Holland tractor and we'll nip up to the yard. Just have a look. It's the shop is up near the biomass heating plant. That's right at the top. So I'm going to have to go up there and get that one. Just thinking, actually, this tractor doesn't have a front weight, and I don't think it can take a front weight either. That tractor over there that is now on the trailer, the slightly bigger tractor, that one does take a front weight, and we're going to need one. So what I think I'll do is if I just move this tractor over here, we will take the Deutz up to the yard, up to the shop, and we will also purchase front weight. Now, the trailer isn't the cheapest. If we take a look in the shop, the header trailer here is this one that we're going to need, I believe. It's the Leguan 24. And it's 5,100, and we've only got 5,900. And if we go back, we're also going to need a front weight. We do have one front weight, but I think we do need another one. This one is 800, this one is 600. We're going to need to buy... We're going to have to end up buying the smallest one, I think. So let me just purchase this one now. Fortunately, these days you've got mobile phones and you can buy things remotely. It's fantastic. It means that we don't have to go up to the shop every time. Right, choose a colour. Well, it is actually a New Holland, so we should stick with yellow because New Holland combines are all yellow. So we will stick with the appropriate colours for it. And let's come over to here. Right, I got 800, so I could buy the mid-range weight, which would be better. I think it will help us with driving that tractor around. So let's come out of here. I will leave the trailer right where it is. And I want to get out of here driving on as little crop as possible, and then we can head on up to the shop, pick up our new purchases. And I will bring the header trailer back to here before I swap over again, and I will pass the header trailer over to the little New Holland, and this one can go back onto the grain carton, and then we can get everything into the field and get ready to start the day's harvest. Right, through the junction here. Job to see anything coming up through the road there. I tend to sometimes just go on a hope and prayer and hope that you get it right. This map really is absolutely gorgeous. Nice little river there, running under us, sound effects and everything. It's fantastic. The level of detail in this map is absolutely brilliant. I am loving it. It's like every time you go around the corner, there's a new little surprise. And I also quite like that we got all these trees hanging over the roads. And it's slightly better that they don't have any collision on them either, because colliding into all those trees all the time would probably get a bit tiresome. What is this? The little village here. So the hedges don't actually have collision on them, so if you do bring a wide machine up through the hedgerows, it's not going to be that much of a problem. The trees don't either. There is a bit of forestry somewhere in the map, but I'm not quite sure where. Now, I believe that you tip hay and straw you sell in there, or at least you sell straw in there. I'm not sure about hay. And the sugar beet, I don't know where the sugar beet store is. This is something that I'm still unsure about. We're going to have a look around for that at another point, but I'm not going to worry about that one today. Right, I'm going to pick up that weight first, and then we will get the trailer on. Let's come around here. Do a decent job of driving, so we'll put that up there and pick that one up. Right, I'll do this from outside the cab. I'll probably do about half and half inside and outside the cab, because inside the cab is really great and all, but some details you just want to be outside the cab to be able to see. And that one will go on to there. Right, now hopefully this is the right header trailer, because if we've got the wrong header trailer and it doesn't actually fit our combine, I'm going to look a bit red-faced, and I'm also going to be out of pocket because I'm down to €68. Although this map is based on the UK, so maybe I should switch over for authenticity to pounds rather than euros. It would probably be better. Let's just take a look at our head trailer here. Along quite nicely. Does look pretty good. It's a good job we don't have collisions, because my driving is awful when I'm trying to look around at everything else. But look at the trees and everything. I mean, it is amazing. This detail that he's got in his map is absolutely fantastic. There's another road that goes off at the side there. I'm not going to worry about that one. I'm just going to keep flying along here. And over this bridge, across the river. Oh, this is amazing. And there's a field that we need to... Oh, I don't actually want to... I'm going to hurry up and get some of this machinery up to the fields. We've got harvest to bring in. And all I've been doing is wandering around the sightseeing. We've got to focus. Yeah, I'm going to have to just back it into this side so that I can unhitch it there. Then come back in and pick up this trailer with this tractor. And then I can take that header trailer with the other tractor on down the road so that we can get the header off the combine. Our work is never done. Right. It would probably help if I was in the cab to see this. There we go. Line it up. The only thing I don't like about this is you can't look out over the back. And when you're hitching up a real-life tractor, you open the back window and you lean right out so that you can see the hitch. It's quite a bit different than doing it in this, I can tell you. Because this one, you don't actually get to lean out, so you can't actually see the hitch. You lean so far out that you can see the hitch underneath the tractor. And it makes all the difference in the world. It really does make it nice and easy to line up, and you've got to get it absolutely perfectly straight and lined up. There's no room for error like there is in this game. One of the reasons I like this game so much, it's much more forgiving. Right, let's go back here. Now, I need to pick this one up. I think I'm going to have to drive on this field, even though it's not ours. Let me just pick that one up. There we go. Now, in order to be able to get out and round there, I think I'm just going to have to apologise and drive over this crop. This is not how to behave. You do not drive on someone else's crop just because you can't get out on the road properly. Come on, Frith, you should know better than that. Now, let me... I am stuck. I'm jackknifing the header trailer, which is also not a good thing to do, because what happens when you jackknife is that it rubs the rubber cleats. Look at that turning point there. Ooh, no. I'm caught on the gate. Oh, this is terrible. I should be able to do this better than this. Come on, round the corner. Yes, there we go, right. Yeah, so if you jackknife, the bar of the trailer rubs against the cleats on the wheel of the tractor, and it can actually rip a wheel in half. It's really bad for your back wheels of your tractor to do something like that. Not so much for the drawbar of the trailer. It doesn't tend to be so much of an issue for the trailer, just for the actual tractor itself. Right, I'm going to have to nip out, push my way through the traffic, and... Oh! Really? Right. We're going to have to swap insurance details for that. Well, I eventually got them to swap insurance details. They did try to drive off, which I thought was a bit poor, really. But anyway, we did deal with that. That's all been sorted. They won't be doing it again in a hurry, I don't think. And now we need to see if this header actually fits on this trailer. I really hope it does, because trying to get this combine up the road without a header trailer is going to be exceedingly difficult. And I feel it was a bit unfair, really, starting us off without a header trailer. I mean, I suppose we could have just gone straight across the road there into that field, but I want to do the oilseed rape first. Canola. That's the other thing, is I tend to call it oilseed rape. It's not necessarily oilseed... Well, it is. In the UK, we call it OSR, oilseed rape. And in the States, and I believe in a lot of Europe, we call it canola. So it's two different... It is the same thing, but because I've spent so much of my life on farms... Right, let's see if I can... How can I take this off? Come back a little bit. Is it going to let me unload? It would help if I selected the header, I think. And... Okay. Oops. I didn't want to do it like that. That wasn't very clever. Okay, let's try picking that up, and we'll try it the other way. And I will put it down. carefully, like that, and then take it off. That's still not working properly. I got a feeling that I've got the wrong header there. I don't think it's for that one. How can we do it? Is there a way to secure it to the trailer? Let's take a look in the tractor. Doesn't seem to be a way to detach. Let's just check in here. We want to go to harvesters, and that one there, suitable for the vary feed, 18 foot, 35 foot, and the draper, or the draper header is a different header altogether. And then we've got these. It doesn't actually say about the header trailers. You got that one and that one, and it doesn't say much about how. Right, I'm sure there must be a way to secure them. Let me climb out and take another look. Because that doesn't seem like a very good way of doing it. Let's get back in the combine and see if we can secure it a little better. There's got to be a better way of doing this. You can tell I don't actually use the header trailers that much when I'm playing farming sim. I tend to get right up to the draper headers and just use those on their own. I thought that there used to be a way that you could fasten them. So onto there and there. And now that's just dropping. So it's sort of going through the bar, but it's staying on there. That's a bit rough, but we'll have to go with it, I think. So let me climb out of here and I'll see if this tractor is actually going to carry the header. There's nothing else that I can do. I move up to the trailer. No, there's no way to sort of prepare it for the header. And see what it does when we drive it round. And there's no way to lock it in place either. Come up round here. That's just going to fall off, isn't it? Hope not. I'm watching it closely. I'm zoomed out like this because I'm watching it to see if there's any sliding. It doesn't look like it. Okay. Take the header on up to the field, and then we'll have to walk back again to the combine. Our wife is doing a lot of running around today, picking us up, so I'm going to have to swing wide around this gateway. And you really had to do that, didn't you? You had to push. You couldn't just let me come out first and stop further back. And again, I think we're going to be here all day. Right, this is a slight problem with busy traffic. There we go. Now we're out round and we're on our way. Right, let's go and get this one up the field and we can come back for the combine. Now all I got to do is get in through that gateway. This might be easier said than done. I'm going to have to swing out round as far as I can to this gate. What I might end up having to do is to back it in. Back it into that. Actually, I think I'm just going to do that. If I just back it in there and then I can drive straight across. Because I don't think I'm just going to be able to swing in round there because it's such a long wheelbase on it. And the swing on the back just makes it that little bit more difficult. So if we reverse in round there we go. And now I can drive straight in. And you don't drive on the crop very much. You try to avoid driving on any of the crop if you can help it. But sometimes you just can't help it, especially when you're near the road. So what you do is you drive up like that as much as you can, a little bit more, and then we just reverse back a little bit so that we're in line with the gateway, and then the combine will come straight in and he'll pick that off, and then we will drive out of his way. Let's go and get the combine. Right then, this should be a lot easier now that we don't have the header on. He's still quite a wide beastie. It's going to be a bit difficult getting him up the road, but it's going to be a lot easier. And just check both ways. Yep, that's good. You've got to remember that he swings out round quite a lot. And you can tell it's been a long time since I've driven a combine by the awful way that I took that approach. And yes, I did spend one summer driving a combine. It was quite good fun, actually. I did enjoy driving a combine. And it wasn't one of these. I drove a class Lexian for a summer, and that is a beautiful combine. That is a very beautiful combine to drive. I'm just going to have to sort of hug the hedge a little bit as much as I can and hope that we don't have any great big ditches or gateposts to fall into. And here we go. It is quite slow driving this around the roads, but we got there in the end. Swing out round. And on we go. I'm getting the hang of driving this again now. It all comes back to it. It's just like riding a bike, driving a combine. It's a tight squeeze up these roads. It really is. So now I got to get in round this gateway, and the gate posts have collision on them. So that's going to make it a bit more interesting. Bit more like real life. So what we do, I'm gonna have to be out of the cab to see this one. We come round here watching the tail and watching the front wheels as well. Now very often you'd have someone spotting for you if you were doing this, and that's fine. Bring it over to here, over to the combine, and yes, you do actually bump right into them. You'd be surprised how rough people are when they pick the headers up. Right, that one's up out the way. Let's climb out of there, get into this tractor, and we will pull this one out the way. Well, I'd like to pull it out the way, except that there's a combine sat on it. So what I'm going to have to do is move the combine backwards so that we can. Ordinarily, I would have thought you'd be able to just pull back a little bit. There we go. And up into the tractor. Right, now we can pull this one out the way. He can sit right in tight on the headland up here, so that he's out the way, and perfect. Right. Tomorrow we will start the actual harvest. We've got the combine here ready, we've got the trailer here ready, we've got the header here ready, everything's ready to go. Tomorrow we will start the harvest. This is going to take a while, I think, this field. But anyway, remember, I said I will ask a question every time. Today's question is, do you want me to keep the withering on or off? I would like, personally, to have it off because we've got so much stuff that we need to harvest. But it's going to be your choice. I will do a vote and I will leave it for a week. I do tend to do most of my recording early in a week, so I will be able to give results of polls the following week. That's kind of how it's going to work, I think. So yes, do you want me to keep the withering on or off? But if you enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give me a like. That would be excellent. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. That would be awesome. Thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.